Modi says BJP is ready to face the challenges that stands on its way to the forthcoming parliamentary election. Indo-Bangla relations continue to be on upward trajectory, says Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Prasar Bharati strengthens mechanism to reach tribal and remotest areas, says IMB Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore. Manipur Governor Dr. Najma Heptullah confers State Kala Academy Awards to 28 persons. And in sports, Assam Badminton Association ready to hold 74th Interstate, Interzonal and 83rd Senior National Badminton Championship in Guwahati. Good evening and welcome to the Northeast News. This is Satwati Bhuya, now the news in details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today said his party is ready to face the challenges that stands on its way to the forthcoming elections. In his Thanksgiving address after President's speech in the parliament, he welcomes healthy competition in the coming parliamentary elections. He said the first-time young voters will be a major factor in building the future of India. During past few years, India has achieved second position in the world, he added, and said that his party will go to people with these achievements.
और उस शक्तिशाली वृक्ष विशाल का है वृक्ष का उगना शुरू हो चुका है विपरीत परिस्थितियों में विकास की आस विश्वास यही देश को आगे ले जाता है चुनौतियों को चुनौती देना ये देश का स्वभाव होता है वही देश चुनौतियों को परास्त करता है जो चुनौतियों से डर के भागते हैं वो नई नई चुनौतियों को मोल लेते हैं और इसलिए चुनौतियों को ही चुनौती देना सामान्य मानवीय की देश की आशा अपेक्षाओं को पूर्ण करने में हम पूरी ताकत से जुटे हुए हैं
Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that India-Bangladesh relations have been on an upward trajectory in the last few years. Interacting with Foreign Affairs Minister of Bangladesh Dr. A.K. Abdul Momen, who called on him at his official residence today, Modi reaffirmed India's commitment to work with Bangladesh to build on this momentum during the new term in office of Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. Dr. Momen briefed the Prime Minister on recent developments in the bilateral relationship. Modi congratulated Dr. Abdul Momen on his appointment as the foreign minister. The foreign affairs minister of Bangladesh arrived in New Delhi yesterday night on a four-day visit to India. During the visit, Momen will attend the fifth India-Bangladesh joint consultative committee meeting tomorrow. The Lok Sabha on its sixth day of budget session completed the question hour. Expressing the happiness, the Speaker Sumitra Mahajan said that she had received several notices on various issues, but the same was not admitted for discussion. The Lok Sabha took up discussion on motion of thanks to President's address. Congress leader Mallikarjun Kharge participating in the discussion said that unemployment is on the rise and the government has failed in its efforts to fill the vacancies. The Rajya Sabha was adjourned for a day as SP, BSP, RJD, TMC and other parties were unrelenting in their protests over changes in the faculty recruitment system in colleges and universities. The agitating members continued sloganeering, leading to the adjournment of the House for the day. Information and Broadcasting Minister Colonel Rajyavardhan Rathore said Prasar Bharati has taken measures to reach its programs in tribal areas located in remotest parts of the country. He said that the role of Prasar Bharati is not revenue generation but to serve the people of the country. Replying to supplementaries in the Lok Sabha, Rathore said that the mandate of the Prasar Bharati is to keep the traditions and culture alive as private channels do not show many things due to commercial reasons. The minister informed the House that All India Radio reaches 99.2% of the total population of the country. He said 39 channels of All India Radio are also available on Doordarshan's DTH platform, which can be accessed across the country. In reply to another question on regular departmental promotion committee for program executives of All India Radio, the minister said DPCs could not be constituted in time in some cases due to litigation. In the budget session of the Assam Legislative Assembly on Thursday, replying to a question by BJP MLA Dilip Kumar Pal, Minister for Transport Chandra Mohan Patwari said, the Transport Department has made use of the land lying vacant at various places across the state to generate revenue, including building a plaza at ASTC Flex Station at Silchar. He said that the department has taken steps to free land from encroachment. Replying to a question posed by BJP MLA Suman Haripriya, Minister for Excise Parimal Suklabadya said, the department is taking rigorous drive against spurious liquor under excise laws. During 2017-18, 12,12,582 litres of illegal country-made liquor have been seized. Replying to a question posed by Congress MLA Abdul Khalik, Industries and Commerce Minister Chandra Mohan Patwari said, over 1 crore rupees have been spent in the Global Investors Summit Advantage Assam in Guwahati on February 3rd and 4th last year. The discussion on the state budget began today, where several MLAs took part. Meanwhile, President of SFI of Assam State Committee Kashyap Chaudhary said that the Assam Budget 2019-20 presented by Finance Minister Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma on Wednesday is nothing but some fireworks. Addressing the media in Guwahati on Thursday, he said that the present budget is only an election-oriented budget and not even 25% of the works promised in the last financial year's budget was implemented so far. The president also said that this year's budget does not have any developmental issue touched upon. The Northeast Indigenous People's Forum, NEIPF, on Tuesday lauded the Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma for taking a bold stand on the Citizenship Amendment Bill 2016, despite NPP being an ally of the BJP-led National Democratic Alliance. Addressing the gathering in Shillong, NEIPF Chief Convener and Alpha Pro Talk leader Anup Chetia said the forum will go all out to oppose the bill. Meanwhile, Chetia also stressed on the need to build a good and friendly relation amongst the indigenous border populace of both Meghalaya and Assam. Leaders of Shiv Sena, a party allied with the present NDA government, have assured to oppose the Citizenship Amendment Bill to CAB 2016 to the delegates of Northeast Students Organization and All Manipur Students Union. The assurance was made in their meeting with Shiv Sena leaders Uddhav Thackeray in Mumbai. General Secretary of NESO Sinam Prakash and AMSU President Sarangthem Manjit represented the state in the team. An executive of AMSU said that the delegation of NESO and AMSU has been meeting with various political parties both in the ruling and opposition in New Delhi since February 2 and urged them to oppose the bill. In their meeting, they briefed all the political parties about the negative impacts which will be faced by people of Northeast once the bill is amended. In Manipur, 28 persons were conferred the Academy Lifetime Achievement Award, Academy Awards and Academy Young Talent Award 2015 for their outstanding contribution in their respective fields in Imphal on Wednesday. Hizam Gora Singh Singh was conferred the Academy Lifetime Achievement Award, which carries a citation and a check of 3 lakh rupees, while Academy Fellow was conferred on Khangembam Mangi Singh and Namerakpam Ongbi Ibemmi Devi, which carries a citation and check for 1 lakh rupees each. The Academy Award was conferred on 19 exponents and the Academy Young Talent Award on 6 others. After presenting the awards, Governor Dr. Najma Hepatullah said that the beauty and popularity of Manipuri culture has not diminished over the centuries due to the hard work and sincere efforts of many illustrious gurus, exponents and practitioners. The Chief of Boroland Territorial Council, Hagrama Mohilari, who is also the President of Boroland People's Front, Hagrama Mohilari, said that the party is all prepared for the coming parliamentary election. Talking to reporters in Kokrajhar today, Mohilari said the party will field candidate in Kokrajhar seat while it will support its ally, the BJP and AGP in other constituency, including Mangaldoi seat. Mohilari said though the AGP has snapped its alliance with the BJP, it is still an ally with the BPF.
ইনভেষ্টমেণ্ট ডে সেইটো অবজাৰ্ভ কৰিবলৈ গৈ আছোঁ। তো আমাৰ প্ৰিপাৰেশ্যনটো এনেকুৱা, আমি ভাবিছোঁ ইয়াত যিটো মাছ গেডাৰিং 10 তাৰিখত অপেন মিটিং।
In Tripura, a team of Special Protection Group SPG arrived in Agartala today and held a meeting with senior police officials to review the security arrangements at Swami Vivekananda ground for Prime Minister Narendra Modi's rally on Saturday. He is scheduled to inaugurate some projects. The SPG team also inspected the rally venue. Security has been reviewed ahead of Modi's visit and asked for coordination between intelligence agencies and security forces. The district administration also beefed up preparations after rounds of high-level meetings. Modi is scheduled to unveil the statue of last king of Tripura, Bir Bikram Manikya, at the airport entry, after whom the airport was renamed. He will straightway go to Vivekananda Stadium to inaugurate the building of India Institute of Information Technology at Tripura Institute of Technology Complex and Garji Belonia railway line by switching remote control. In Assam, the 74th Interstate, Interzonal and 83rd Senior National Badminton Championship 2018-19 will kick-start from 10th to 16th February, said Omar Rashid, Assam Badminton Association Secretary. Addressing the media in Guwahati on Thursday, Rashid also said that iconic badminton players of India like Saina Nehwal, P.V. Sindhu, K. Srikanth, H.S. Pranoy, Ashwini Ponappa and many more are going to take part in the event. The total prize money for the 5 events during the championship is 50 lakhs, he added. More than 650 players are going to participate. The tournament is allotted by Badminton Association of India and is organized by Assam Badminton Association, he said. Boro Sahitya Sabha, in collaboration with Sahitya Academy, today organized 3rd Boro Writers Festival in Dhekiajuli. Inaugurating the two-day festival, Regional Secretary of Eastern Region Sahitya Academy, Devendra Kumar Devesh, said children literature is an important component for the development of a language or literature. Terming Boro language as a rich one, he also stressed on the need to popularize literature in rural areas mainly. At the inaugural session, President of Boro Sahitya Sabha Taran Boro, General Secretary Prasanta Boro and Convener of Boro Advisory Board Sahitya Academy Anil Boro were also present. Notably, Boro Poets Meet, Young Writers Meet and other interactive programs with writers were the main agenda of the festival. In Meghalaya, almost 2 months since 15 miners were trapped inside a rat hole mine in Kasan village in East Jaintia Hills district. Rescue teams have so far managed to pull out the body of only one miner, while body of another has been detected but yet to be retrieved. As the rescue operations continue, it was informed that the services of Odisha pumps are no longer required at present with the use of submersible pumps of other companies, hence utility has been suspended for last 2 days. The Odisha team has left for their respective state today. Before winding up, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says BJP is ready to face the challenges that stands on its way to the forthcoming parliament election. Indo-Bangla relations continue to be on upward trajectory, says Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Prasar Bharati strengthens mechanism to reach tribal and remotest areas, says IMB Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore. Manipur Governor Dr. Najma Hepatullah confers State Kala Academy Awards to 28 persons. And in sports, Assam Badminton Association ready to hold 74th Interstate, Interzonal and 83rd Senior National Badminton Championship in Guwahati. That brings us to the end of this evening's bulletin. Thank you for tuning in. Namaskar.